Okay, so first we need the candy. Do that one. What's up guys, back with another video. In this video I'm just going to talk about all the trades that happened in the NBA yesterday, just because I'm running out of things to talk about, so just going to discuss that and get on with it. Please like this video and subscribe. So in the first trade we had Andre Iguodala from Memphis go to the Miami Heat. I'm really a fan of that trade. You know, he's as a Cavs fan, we didn't like him because he was on Golden State for most of his career. But he's a really good defender. He's a really good defender. He won MVP, finals MVP for that. So I really do think he can help the Miami Heat for sure. And that's just another stepping stone to them getting to the top of the East and maybe even the NBA Finals. So I really do think that's a good piece that they got. Really good piece. The next one was the Rockets trading their center Clint Capela to the Hawks. That was surprising to me. That was surprising. That just means that the NBA is wanting to go small. They're getting basically all the centers are leaving. A lot of teams are wanting to go smaller. I do think it's a dumb mistake because the Rockets have to play a lot of teams that have pretty good big guys. Pretty good big guys. And they're not going to be able to guard them if they don't have anyone that can match up with them. So I think in a way it helps the Hawks next year when they can have Trae Young and Clint Capela. Pick and roll, all that. But for the Rockets, I really don't think that will help them. It might help them in the regular season because no one has to game plan a lot. But when you get to the postseason, it slows down. Teams have time to regroup and prepare for each game. And I really don't think trading Clint Capela was a good decision. It really wasn't. Another piece that was involved in the Miami-Memphis trade was Justice Winslow. You know, he's a good point guard. I loved watching him in Miami. He can shoot and he can drive. He can do a lot of things. I really think he's going to bring the grit and the grind to Memphis. I mean, they're just a really good young team. And they got all their picks basically from the draft. So Memphis is going to be a good, solid young team in the future. And they're just adding on to that with Justice Winslow. So they're going to be pretty damn good in a couple years. You also had a couple other smaller trades from Sacramento to Atlanta just for some cash value, just to add to their taxes. So those weren't really major trades, but just wanted to mention that. All right, the next big one, you had the Golden State Warriors trade D'Angelo Russell to the Minnesota Timberwolves for Andrew Wiggins. That is a good trade for both teams. They both needed, Minnesota needed a point guard, obviously, to go along with Kat. That'll be a good pick and roll scenario. You'll have shooting, you'll have inside play. I mean, it's a great trade for them. Also, you have Andrew Wiggins, who I believe can still reach his full potential, and he's going to a great team that can help him with that. With Steph Curry, Draymond, when all of them aren't hurt, Andrew will be a good piece to pass it to. He's a good spot-up shooter, good defender. It's a good trade for both teams, and sadly, the Warriors got better. I mean, they're going to be really good next year. They have a pick, probably number one or two pick in the draft, and they also just got Andrew Wiggins, a good 3-and-deep player. It's going to be a pretty solid year for the Warriors next year. But all in all, that was a good trade for both teams. No one really lost that trade. So I mean, I guess the only team that really lost is Phoenix because they should have gotten a point guard, but it passed them. So that was a good trade for Minnesota and Golden State. All right, now my favorite one. The Cleveland Cavaliers traded basically nothing to the Detroit Pistons for Andre Drummond, all-star Andre Drummond. This just proves that the league is going small. You know, we just got, the Cavs got a center for like honestly nothing. 2023 second round pick. But Andre Drummond's an all-star to go along with Kevin Love. And you got the two young guys at the guard position, Colin Sexton, Darius Garland. The Cavs could make some moves next year, possibly. We just got to get some shooters. The Cavs got to get some shooters. Keep it moving. But all in all, that was a win for Cleveland. A big, big loss for Detroit. They're stupid to trade him for that. They're stupid to do that. But, yeah, it was a win for Cleveland for sure. So the last big trade of the day that happened yesterday was Marcus Morris from the New York Knicks getting traded to the Clippers. That's a big, big move. Big move, and the Clippers won the LA sweepstakes because of that. You're talking about the Clippers, who are already defensively heavy, to now add on Marcus Morris, who has the presence of like a huge defender. He can shoot. He's basically a really good 3-and-deep guy. He brings that the Clippers, and they were in a battle from the Lakers and the Clippers who was going to get him. So I think adding the Marcus Morris is a big stepping stone to them winning this offseason if they were to match up, the Lakers and the Clippers. Obviously, the Knicks didn't win this trade. I mean, they never win anything. But the Clippers are going to – that's a big move for the Clippers, for sure. Huge move. And there's also rumors going around that former point guard for the Indiana Pacers, Darren Collison, he retired last year, but the Lakers need a point guard. They really need a point guard, and I think if they could pick him up, that'll be a really good piece. He plays defense, he can shoot, he can do a lot of things. I really do believe they can do a lot with him, so that'd be a big, big piece if they can sign him. Also, if they can get J.R. Smith, I mean, he's a shooter. He might be dumb at times, but he can shoot, he can play defense, same thing. Those would be some good pickups for them if they can get him. So who do y'all think won the trade deadline yesterday? Comment in the comment section down below your favorite team and if you think they did pretty good yesterday. And again, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Peace. In Vegas, yeah, I drink Jaeger. Four bangers get serenaded by ladies basically naked. It's crazy, this life I take it. Yeah, everybody know this. White girls drink vodka sodas. Jack and Cokes will get you open. Tequila shots are the dopest. And I love it, the way you look so fine when I'm faded on my tension and tonic. But keep on getting persuaded that I want it. Crack the Jameson, invite all your lady friends. Tell that bartender, serve a motherfucking round again. Tell that bartender, make that motherfucker stronger. I wanna go all night longer. A couple rounds going down like water. I wanna go all night longer. Cause I do this every night. I wanna do this every night. A couple rounds going down. Tequila, red wine, and Stoli. Yeah, I mix it, had some beers before this liquor. Now I'm shit-faced at the bar, but my game's never been sicker. Shoot whiskey like a cowboy, both